there has been a resiliency with this Nets team this season. Games where you think it's just not going to happen on a given night, they've shown that they can turn it around. This was an 18-point lead for the Houston Rockets early. Nets answered quite a few times. Houston always seemed to have a response, but then finally in the fourth quarter, the tide turned. Kyrie Irving controlled the action. Blake Griffin, major contributor. Joe Harris, major contributor. Nicholas Claxton, major contributor. You're seeing a theme. They did it without James Harden in that final quarter.
That's important to remember, that they did this without James Harden. And, of course, our thoughts are with him as we continue to find out more about the severity of his hamstring. But the fact that he has been such an integral part, not only to what the Nets are doing, but in closing time.
Yep.
And the Nets' ability to make plays. And there was a shift just in energy, in execution, in focus in those final 5-6 minutes of the game where they exceeded the energy of what we saw at Houston. Give the Rockets credit. They came in with an excellent game plan. Not only were they doing a nice job on the defensive end, but they were knocking down shots and yep. They were being aggressive on the attack. But it's been a theme that we've seen for Brooklyn, not only the contributions in different players at different moments throughout the game, but they have the ability to get timely stops, and that was key in how they closed out.
Prior to the game, Steve Nash admitted he likes ugly wins. He has no problem with winning ugly. This was not an ugly win by any stretch. I think where Steve's issue came into play in previous games, not finishing strong, not getting to the closing line in the way in which they envisioned. Different story tonight. The strength came in how they ended the game, and a good sign for the fact that the Nets are hearing what the coaching staff has to say and then going out and executing it.
That's what it's about. And what we have talked about throughout the course, particularly the last few weeks is even if you don't feel like you're playing your best basketball, you're still learning these lessons by winning. But we've seen those adjustments. We've seen the improvement. And I think for all of these players, finding some of that juice, finding some of the motivation when you're in the dog days of the season, but still stringing together wins. And overall, it was a nice sight to see. Of course, Kyrie Irving was special once again. Joe Harris, big numbers, but we understand he's a clutch knockdown shooter. Nicholas Claxton continuing to come into his own, seeing how Blake Griffin is starting to fit into this rotation. Once again, Bruce Brown and his fit. So all of these aspects are important for the process for how this Nets team is coming together.
And one of the surprise teams in the NBA this season, the Charlotte Hornets, up next, second half of a back-to-back. And you mentioned it, Sarah. Nets are going to get the best shot that every team has, and that will include a Charlotte team that is highly motivated to make the postseason, playing right now without LaMelo Ball.
Playing without LaMelo Ball, but still currently they're sitting in that four spot in the East. They're coming off of a win against Washington, and not long before that, they played Phoenix, a hot Phoenix team, very tough. They beat Miami, and they found a great deal of continuity, and especially for James Borrego as he continues to implement his system and what he's looking for out of these guys after the past few years of taking the reins. I think it's been really interesting to watch how they've been able to flirt and come together. So it's going to be a tough task for the Nets as they turn around here tomorrow night at Barclays.
19-3 in their last 22 games, and they are officially in the number one spot in the Eastern Conference with this victory over Houston.